Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Today, and we're back again with some latest news for you. Let's begin with our first news regarding SpaceX Starship landing leg concept. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk has been pointing out for a long time developing newer versions of landing legs for SpaceX's Starship. After SN10 has created the history of becoming the first Starship prototype to land in one piece instead of landing leg problems, SpaceX is now moving for a series of upgrades for their next prototypes. SpaceX has suffered a problem in deploying the landing legs during the SN10 test, so they're keeping in mind to create such a new design which would significantly improve reliability, stability, and durability. In the meantime, Erc X, a graphic artist who's also a fan of SpaceX, brought forth a design of landing legs as a suggestion for the new upcoming Starship rockets. Erc X tweeted on the 5th of March with a graphic illustration of the landing legs. "Based on the new Dear Moon renders, I've modeled some possible Starship leg designs. Only question is, how will they work? Here are a couple of different options. Please tell me what you think," he tweeted. During SN10's historic landing, some of the legs out of the total 6 legs of Starship failed, forcing it to land in a tilted way. Leo of Terminal Count tweeted, "So the landing legs did deploy, but if you look closely, some of them didn't lock in place. You can see them dangling. I don't think they would have made much difference anyway, given the touchdown velocity." Credit at Lab Padre. Though the landing velocity was reduced by a large extent, yet it was nearly 10 to 15 miles per hour, relatively fast for soft landing. As a result, Starship crushed some of its legs, leaning the rocket tilted to a side with a few inches of ground clearance. Though the vehicle exploded a few minutes after touchdown, landing the giant was definitely a hard one. The SpaceX team had done it and achieved historic success. SpaceX is gathering data from the SN10 mission and is also analyzing the shortcomings of SN10. They'll use this data and analysis for carrying out flawless Starship tests and missions in the future. SpaceX has given some landing upgrades in an update prior to Starship SN10's successful launch. Landing and self-destruction. SpaceX renders, released as part of the update for a private Starship launch around the moon, has also revealed hints of certain changes in the landing leg design. With successfully completing the Starship SN10's landing, SpaceX is gearing up for the Starship's SN11 completion and also SN15 in the line, up to SN18. Several upgraded landing leg equipment are expected to appear very soon at SpaceX's Boca Chica, Texas factory. The concept and design of the landing legs, brought forth by Erc X, is a follower of the previous landing leg concept issued by SpaceX earlier. But Erc X has modified the design further. He's shown many different possible landing leg versions that could easily be installed inside the trapezoidal covers visible on SpaceX's latest official Starship updates. SpaceX has also given a hint about their next-gen landing legs. Instead of using 6 narrower legs, Starship can use 4 broader legs protruding from the 4 sides, covering a larger area. Let's move to our second story for today, related to NASA hikes prices. On the 25th of February, NASA had announced that they're revising their commercial marketing pricing policy, which they'd published nearly 2 years ago as part of a new low Earth orbit commercialization strategy. That policy comprises a price list for resources such as cargo to and from the station and crew time. NASA has increased the price it charges for commercial users of the International Space Station for cargo and other resources by a large extent. This huge change in price has tensed some companies, especially commercial users. In the statement published on NASA's website, NASA said that they're updating the price list to reflect full reimbursement for the value of NASA resources. NASA also said that they're taking the decision after conducting discussions with stakeholders, analyzing the current market growth, and they're also hoping for getting future commercial entities capable of providing similar services. Jeffrey Manber, chief executive of NanoRacks, said, "NASA has not done a good job communicating with the stakeholders. We're in discussions with customers and suddenly we're being notified of a major increase. Manber said that the sudden increase in prices has forced Nanorax to suspend discussions with their two potential customers. After removal of the subsidy, the prices of those services went up significantly. The price to be charged for transporting 1 kilogram of cargo up to the station, up mass, rose from $3,000 to $20,000. The price to be charged per kilogram down to Earth, down mass, increased from $6,000 to $40,000. Charge of 1 hour of crew member time rose from $17,500 to $130,000. NASA said, nearly 2 years have passed since NASA released the initial pricing policy. The pricing policy from June 2019 did not reflect full reimbursement for the value of NASA resources. It was intended to stimulate the market and was planned to be adjusted. Manber said that NASA may be reacting to language in a report accompanying the final fiscal year 2021 appropriations bill, which provided NASA with just $17 million for LEO commercialization efforts, compared to its request of $150 million. NASA also points out that there's been a solid demand for commercial and marketing activities from both traditional aerospace companies and from novel industries. The report states, it's clear that no appropriated funds could be used to subsidize certain commercial use activities. Thus, less than full reimbursement was determined to be inconsistent with the report language. Other activities that are educational in nature, or scientific or research and development, can and should fly via the International Space Station U.S. National Laboratory. There is no change to process or costs for these activities. Manber also said, I believe there are commercial projects, along with education efforts and partners, that bring value to the International Space Station. They show American leadership. There's a nuanced discussion that needs to be made with Congress and NASA. At last, Manber says, I'm hopeful that this is the beginning of a dialogue on more mature support for commercialization. The LEO commercialization policy has enabled private astronaut missions to the ISS, on one hand, and also provides a price list for resources, such missions on the other hand. The price list charges $22,500 per person per day for crew supplies and $11,250 per person per day for life support. Our next news for today is regarding Perseverance moves on Mars. On the 5th of March, NASA officials said that the Perseverance rover has made the first move on the land of the Red Planet. They stated this during an ongoing press briefing at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory. Perseverance has landed on the Jezero crater in Mars on the 18th of February. According to the NASA officials, Perseverance has moved forward by 4 meters. It's turned around 150 degrees to the left side and then moved 2.5 meters backward. NASA's rover has started roaming on the Martian surface as mission scientists are gearing up to send the rover toward a dead river delta to find signs of life from the past. Anais Zarifian, Perseverance Mobility Testbed Engineer, said at the briefing, our first drive went incredibly well. I don't think I've ever been happier to see wheel tracks. The Martian rover also captured images of marks of the tracks created by its wheels on the Martian soil. Robert Hogg, Perseverance Deputy Mission Manager, said at the briefing, we haven't had any hardware issues. Everything's been working that we've been checking out. It's actually been amazingly smooth. NASA officials said that the first drive by the rover is carried out for thorough checkouts of the rover and adaptability of its instruments in the Martian surface. Perseverance will later deploy Ingenuity, a small helicopter designed to fly on the Martian surface. The helicopter will come out from the rover's undercarriage and carry out flight tests scheduled to last for a month. After Ingenuity comes out, Perseverance will move on to the Delta River. Hogg said that engineers are now searching for a perfect place suitable for conducting the flight tests. Scientists are capturing photos using the rover. These photos will help to find out the suitable location. To quote Hogg, we're still analyzing various areas to determine the best place to do that. We hope to get the whole helicopter thing going before spring is over. Project officials said that engineers will continue to test the equipment installed in the rover. Sample collection systems will also be tested. Hogg said commissioning of the sample collection system will be completed after the helicopter tests. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.